a dead body story. Well, me and my five friends in the 50s used to hang out with a very charismatic young boy in a white t-shirt. One day he said, "Do you want to see a dead body?" And I said, "You're River Phoenix." No, a carcass. Okay. So recently So I have shared custody with my daughter. She's three, and, you know, my ex-wife and I live a year? mile apart? That was literally Freudian. So we're a mile apart, and it's mostly smooth. I think the hardest part is on my daughter, who has to walk between both houses. I'm working on that one. But anyway, so... they had a hairless cat and we had a fish. That was like the two household pets. And the fish died. I go on the road a lot and the fish died. And I was like freaking out. I was like, how am I gonna break it to my daughter that the fish is dead? Am I gonna have to do like the sitcom thing and like get a new fish that's like, hey, I'm the old fish. You know, like get one with the chops. And then, I let it, this is the worst part, I couldn't decide what to do, so I just let it be in the tank for like 4 days while I was like, what do I do about this fish? Maybe I thought like on day four he'd be like, I was just kidding. So I eventually have to dump it because I'm like, this is going to start looking disgusting. And I dump the fish. And it's been 2 weeks. And she hasn't even asked.
Oh my God.
And the lesson is, if you're a parent, you're trying too hard.
Oh.
Yeah.
Dad, what's a funeral?
Oh. First, why do you ask?
I heard it on the news.
Oh, okay. Well, funerals, when a person dies, we have a ceremony for them to lay them to rest.
Oh. What's a clearance sale on mattresses?
Well, why do you ask?
Who's a commercial after that new segment?
A clearance sale just means they're getting rid of all their mattresses, so they're on sale. They drop the prices. To clear them out of the mattress or something.
Now I got one last unrelated question.
Okay.
What are ladies in lace?
Ask your mother.
Hey, Mom.
She's 1 mile that way. See ya. See ya, son.
Mom!
Oh, must be my son!
Oh, sorry, I'm late, Dad. Sorry.
Just making you cookies.
Google Maps said it only takes 6 months. It took a lot longer. Mom? What's a funeral?
Oh, well, that's when a part of you dies when your ex-husband leaves.
Oh, your answer was different than Dad's. Well, Susie, it's me. It's your time traveling dad. I'm back.
What?
You got any beer in here?
So good to see you.
Yeah.
You look so young.
Oh, you know, it's.
Well, so... Susie, it's me. Your time traveling dad. Oh, sorry. My bad.
Come back. Come back.
Nope, I'm sorry.
He actually looks a little more familiar to me, like the age range that I was used to.
Well, you know, it's one of the conditions of being a time-traveling dad.
I did want to just get why I was here.
Hey, yeah.
Great job, me. Took the last beer. Real cool.
That's right. That's
my favorite beer.
That's why I said come back.
Don't let me get in the middle of this or anything, but I mean, can you have beer when you're time... Okay. Time travel is a thing. That's great. Yeah.
Well, that's why I'm your time-traveling dad. That's literally what I say every time I come into the room.
But isn't there something that...
In fact, I'm pretty sure there's like a third me coming in here.
Yeah, there it is.
I'm too early!
You time travel. You can, like, go back in time and fix stuff.
Oh, trust me, we've been down that route. It never ends well. You have sex with Hitler just now? Yep, that's... It didn't help.
You try to stop the election or something, you can do all kinds of stuff. You know, you can just go back a little bit and tell everybody how bad everything is. It didn't work either?
Also, I keep appearing in your closet, which is super disconcerting. It's very, very odd.
Alright, well, I wish you wouldn't drink all my beer. Can you bring some future beer next time you come? I'd like to see what they're doing with it.
Well, I'll see what I can do. Hold on, let me, I'll be back in, like, a couple of years, alright?
But it'll really be, like, not
hey,
a long time, though.
Hey, it's your father, your time-traveling father from the future.
Hey, good to see you again, Dad.
Things looking real different in the future, and it's great.
Yeah. Oh, it is good. Mm-hmm. Oh, great.
Got a little upgrade.
Welcome to Pet Heaven. Oh, let me tell you about the wonderful funeral my family gave for me. Wonderful. Tell me more.
Goldie, you were the best. And we're going to miss you so much.
All right, it's all done. It's done now.
Yeah, it was so peaceful.
That was beautiful. I was ripped apart by another beta fish.
What'd they do with your body?
All right. Ziploc bag. Random drawer.
Door to hell opening.
From the watery depths of Hades?
I'm a scary octopus.
Oh, we're gonna fucking break here,
but this was before the entire city of San Francisco was like paved with diamonds, and there were still like bad neighborhoods and stuff, and so we lived in the bad neighborhood, and I fell in with this group of kids that were like undesirable or whatever, and we were hanging out, and it was called Bernal Heights, and there was a mountain, like a hill, it's hard to explain, it was I don't know. San Francisco's weird, but there was a hill, and on top of it was like a some tower. It was before a cell phone, so I don't even know what the tower was for. But there a road would go around this hill like this, like all the way up. And we would just go play on it all the time because it was like steep and dangerous, and that's what kids do. So there was five of us. And the oldest kid, Eddie, was like a bad kid. He had a wrist rocket. And he was like amazing with it, and he'd shoot it like so far. So one day we're on like picture the road going around this hill like this. And we're on like the third one up, just hanging out, being weird and being kids. And cars would sometimes drive up the hill. So if you were on a top part, you could see a car coming around the bottom. And one day we're like, why aren't we throwing rocks at these cars? I don't know who said that, but everybody else was like, I know! So we all grab a rock, and we see this white car start driving up the bottom thing. And we all, like, as five, as a unit, go like that. And I was a varsity shortstop, so whatever. But I had an arm ever since I was a kid. And I threw mine, and they all threw theirs, and they were like, whatever, and they like walked away immediately. I threw mine, and I don't know if anybody here has played like organized sports or like has ever been a quarterback on a foot. There's something about throwing an object where you know when you did it right, mm-hmm. that you know as soon as it leaves your fingers. Like it's impossible to explain, but every professional athlete knows what I'm talking about. So I throw this rock, and this rock is like this, but it's a big rock, and I go. And as soon as it leaves my fingers, I'm looking at the car and I go, oh fuck, like that's definitely going in that fuck. Like this car's going 35 miles an hour. The math of this thing happening is so fucking out of, you could have Nolan Ryan topical reference. who's new? Who's like a good pitcher now? Anyway,
Clayton Kershaw.
Great! So, Clayton Kershaw. Do that, and you could give him 50 fucking tries, and he wouldn't get anywhere near this car. Yeah. That's how hard this was. And I go, and I see it, and I'm like, ah! It goes down straight through the middle of the windshield. Ooh. And this is like so far. And so there's nowhere to run. It's a hill, and it's just, you just go up, and then it's done. It's like an ice cream
tower.
With a tower at the top. So we hear, like, you know, and glass shatter.
Wow.
And all the other kids were like, who did that? And I was like, yeah, who did that? I mean, come on. You should all feel responsible. So we just turn around and start running up the hill, even though a car could just keep going around. Anyway, they find us. There's nowhere for us to go. And it's two dudes, and they're like mid-20s, and it's an old, it's like a 67 white Mustang that they had just restored.
Oh,
so then, yeah, I know. So I don't remember exactly how it happened, but like I was like too young to have, like to be, what do you call it, savvy or whatever. So they were just so mad and older that I was like, I did it. Like I just fucking came clean like a blubbering asshole. And they're like, where do you live? And I was like, this address. I could have been like, go fuck yourself, and just ran, and it would have been fine. But I was just like, so anyway, here's how it ends. So they go, they drive, they don't give me a ride, they just drive to my address that I gave them.
Oh wow,
wow.
And it's my real address because I'm a fucking idiot. And they knock on the door. Anyway, I come home later and I'm a mess. I know I'm going to get in trouble. It's just my mom. My dad's still at work. And I'm terrified of my dad, but not my mom. So she goes, these two guys came over. Anyway, long story short, these guys turned out to be such assholes as like people that she goes, as soon as I was talking for like 3 seconds, I was like, you know what? I'm glad my fucking kid threw a rock through your fucking windshield. Get the fuck out of my face. And they drove away. And so I heard my mom through the wall tell my dad while I was freaking out in my bed. She goes, you know what? He shouldn't have done it, but they were fucking dick faces. You gotta say something so he doesn't do that again. But like, I don't. Fuck those guys. So I remember my dad comes in and he goes, you hit a fucking Mustang going 35 miles an hour? And I go, yeah, I'm so sorry. And he's like, yeah,
Nolan Ryan, look, time out. Listen to the pitching coach, okay? Mm-hmm. You get a strike, it's great, all right?
Yeah.
You can't just walk away, okay?
But I did it.
No, right. Yeah, you got to strike them all out. First inning, all right? You're doing a great job. Just keep it on.
That's right.
Yeah, but yeah, I just, okay, I'll focus. I'm here.
I'm ready. Rodriguez is ready. Let's do this.
Stop saying your name. Stop saying your own name, Rodriguez.
Yeah, all right. Yeah,
all right. Yeah, that's good. Rodriguez.
Right, you got it. Back on the bat. You can't flick him off.
No.
You can't flick him off.
Oh, it's a ball. It's a ball.
All right. At least celebrate when it's a great pitch. Rodriguez, anything?
Rodriguez thinks you should probably like
I thought there was someone on that base. All right. Whoa! Oh, he's running. Oh. Stop throwing it to me! I'm supposed to stay here! No! Well, now he's at home. Thanks, guys! Thanks! Rodriguez, what the hell?
Listen, Rodriguez was trying, alright? Yeah. Ball was coming by real fast.
Well, someone was playing by the rules and staying put.
Rodriguez had a plan. Right? Rodriguez knows the rules to this game.
I'd like to hear it.
Okay? All right.
Enlighten Nolan Ryan.
Rodriguez is about to enlighten Ryan right now.
Sosa wants to know if we're going to play a game or not.
Sosa, you get back.
Okay, Sosa's going back.
Get out of here, Sosa.
Rodriguez is done with Sosa.
We're all done with Sosa.
Well, I mean, really done with him, right? He should be retired, right? Rodriguez knows all about what's going on. Isn't he? No. Oh, God.
It's so beautiful up here, right? It's so beautiful. Top of the Empire State Building, Mom and Dad.
Yeah, I'm not going over there. Can you back away from that?
No.
Can you back away from it a little bit?
I feel incredible, honey.
Hey, Dad.
I'm just a charismatic guy with a white t-shirt on.
Hey, Dan.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, guys.
Why are we not throwing loose change off of this?
Hey, I got some loose change for you.
Guys, you could kill people with loose change.
No, honey, he's got a good idea.
This man has loose change.
I'm serious.
Don't hit mine, everyone. Should I do one or all of them?
Oh, anyone want a cigarette? Hey, kid.
Yeah. Guys, oh my God. Guys, I'm serious.
It sounds like an incredible idea.
Stop it from...
Could someone light it? It's just in my mouth.
For the children, thank you so much.
Don't
here it goes.
My own child is
I'm making
sick.
A hail.
Means a lot to me, my own child.
Down it goes.
My husband also died at a young age, so I'm really honored you have.
It's a hell of
thank
a
so
toss, kids.
Well, you couldn't have planned that.
I was next going to ask if you wanted to see a dead body, but you already have.
Oh, my God, it's a dead body. It's really far away. Can I have a light?
Sure, kid.
Stop him. Stop him from...
I'm so proud right now. You don't understand.
You should be.
Thank you, sir.
Get away from the edge.
Just call me the ghost of River Phoenix.
Die, River
that's
Phoenix.
Two dead bodies.
Okay, our son has lingered dangerously close to the edge, has probably killed a person, and is smoking. Can we go now?
No, I don't want. I want to make sure this is not like some kind of fluke. I want you to throw another one.
Where's the ghost of River Phoenix?
I'm over here.
Oh, hey.
I want a cigarette.
I'm out of chains, Dad.
Guys, stop it. Stop
here's
it.
A dollar, a coin.
That is really heavy! That is gonna hurt someone in like 3.5 minutes. Oh shit, a dollar.
I had high hopes for you, son. You dashed him.
I thought it was a man.
Let's go to the gift shop!
Thank you.
Oh!
Officer, I ain't telling you nothing.
Look, you, we found you at the scene,
alright? Alright, I did it, alright?
Okay.
Try to crack me. I'm like an egg.
Okay, so...
Easily cracked!
So, yeah, you were at the scene, and so you're admitting that you,
maybe?
Robbed that store.
Maybe? Who's to say I've ever been in the liquor store on 54th Street?
Were you?
Right at the corner of Alton Avenue.
That's exactly where it was.
7:33 p.m.? I may or may not own an Apple Watch. You can check it in evidence. You can track my exact position with that.
Right.
I have all the options unlocked.
We were gonna
trust the NSA implicitly.
All right, well, you're pleading innocent, but...
I am not guilty, is my plea.
I'm very confused on your testimony right now.
Very guilty.
What? No, that's... You've said not guilty, but then you keep giving me more details.
I trust the jury to do what is right.
Where the hell is your lawyer?
I will be representing myself.
That is a terrible idea.
I'll just make my opening statement.
Right. We haven't even had the opening statement. That's a good point.
Who the hell took the top bunk?
It's me. I did it. Also, I found the shiv. I wasn't sure who it was. If you'd like it, you can. I trust you to the right thing. This must be right.
I'm sorry. What? I don't get it.
I'm writing, I will not blow spitballs at Mrs. Jenkins.
I just don't understand why that's a valid form of punishment. I don't get it.
Okay, all right.
Why does
Principal,
she, why does it matter?
Principal Marcus, can I talk to you for just a second?
I mean,
but
not
in front of the...
I don't get it.
Okay,
yeah.
All right.
This is a spitball. It's kind of funny, right?
You said I couldn't use the paddle anymore. All right?
Yeah, we're not supposed to hit kids. They're very clear
right.
on that.
Okay. No, no, and we learned that this is what I thought was the best punishment.
That's
okay?
Like the thing they do at the beginning of The Simpsons. You remember that? So
yeah.
It's different, like, if you watch it. Yeah, that's dumb.
Yeah.
See, Bart Simpson never learned his lesson. He was doing shenanigans, like,
it's just invalid. Look at her face right now.
Look at the mischief on her face. Excuse me. Let me show you how to... relate to
by
children.
All means. By
show
all
you
means.
How to relate to children.
Sure.
Hey, you think it's pretty cool what you did, right?
Yeah.
What would it take? So you gotta negotiate a little bit. What would it take to I mean, I think it's funny.
I'm right here.
On a very special episode of The Simpsons. Bart.
Yeah.
Looks me I'm a new character here in Springfield. I just moved in. I'm voiced by Donald Glover. Very comforting. I feel like you are reaching out. You need a lot of help. And I just want to be here to hear you. You know, I heard your dad's got a drinking problem. Your parents' marriage is not great. Your father's elderly and has some medical issues. Your mother's parents ran out. That's right. I know a lot about this town, even though I just moved here.
You pay attention.
Yeah,
whatever.
I pay attention because you're worth paying attention to, Bart. Can I call you Bartholomew? Yeah, it's a religious name. He's one of the disciples. He was one of those who was closest to Christ. Can I witness to you? Is that all right?
You know,
this would be a good time to come out and say hello. I'm Jesus. Voiced by... That's right. Gary Busey.
Yep.
And I'd like to echo everything that he's about to say. Bartholomew is a wonderful biblical name.
Can I say something?
Sure,
please.
Okay.
It's your chance to really have your voice
heard.
A
lot of people have had this talk with me.
Really?
Like, of people
okay.
with, like, voices you would recognize have had the same talk with me. And you know what? Nothing has changed. I am the same person every time. So, before you deliver a long and, like, thought out speech to me,
yeah.
I want you to know that after you leave, and maybe a couple hours after that, nothing will have changed.
You mean at the end of this, you know, approximately 18 to 22 minute conversation?
next week you're going to be the same?
I'm going to be exactly the same.
Do you mean to tell me that there'll be a montage in which we see a slow progression?
Yeah.
But
if you learn your lesson?
I will have learned the lesson and then unlearned it so I can learn a new one next
nihilism,
time.
The nihilism, the nihilism.
Come on, kids! Let's go up. This is where the kids of the hill live.
Oh,
yeah,
great.
Yeah.
This
is a bad neighborhood.
That's right.
Yeah,
this is gonna be fun.
I hear. I hear your Prius doesn't even have leather.
That's right.
Yeah. I heard it actually takes like full like diesel. Like it's a diesel Prius.
Yeah. You're making fun of my car, guys.
Yeah. You can hear it when it runs.
Yeah. I heard your reusable bags are from Bilo.
Right.
I heard they just reused the plastic ones.
I've heard that too.
Look, you damn rich kids gotta just move along, all right? Quit being dicks, okay?
Seriously, don't.
Huh?
You just called us the D word?
Yeah.
Well, you're making fun of my, like, normal car and my normal trash bag.
We're just having a conversation.
We're just having a conversation.
Fun, you're hitting me in the soul here. This is my, I built this car from the ground up.
You built a Prius?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
That is remarkable.
Yeah, and you guys are shitting all over it, so why don't you just scoot?
I kind of feel bad.
I know. Perchance the children of the hill have something to teach.
Okay. Everything's temporary. I got kidnapped twice. Yeah, when I was a kid, for real.
Jesus, what?
Wow.
Yeah, I know. I was pretty good looking. So no, that's not why it's funny. So the first time, I'm only gonna tell the one time. Not gonna tell both. So I was. Remember when I mentioned that you in the old days in the 80s. Your family would let you just go play. I would go play at the playground by myself when I was like 5 or 6 years old. And it was like 3 blocks from my house in San Francisco. And one time I'm playing in the sand, and all of a sudden, and there's kids around me, and there's kind of parents, but not really. And all of a sudden, I just remember this vividly. No, a dark brown sweaty arm goes like this around my mouth and pulls me out of the sand box, throws me in the back of a windowless van, and drives away. And I wasn't even scared, because already at 6, in school in the 80s, you heard how many kids got kidnapped all the time. They're like, do not get kidnapped. Like, it sucks. And I just thought it was, like, my turn. So, I'm like, well, here we go. Let's see what happens. And then turns out earlier that day, my friend had been picking on this kid. And so I'm in the back of this van, and the guy turns around, and he's yelling at me. And then I look up, and in the front passenger seat of the van is the kid that my friend had been picking on, and he ripped his shirt that day. And so he came home, and his dad was like, who ripped your shirt? We're going around the neighborhood looking for him.
Oh, my God. Wow.
So they looked around for him, and they couldn't find my friend, but they found me. And the kid was like, that's him. So he literally pulled me out of a sandbox in front of all these people and threw me in the back of a brown van, which he's not technically kidnapping me to, like, have sex with me for 20 years, but, like, they don't know that.
Yeah.
So he goes, so I see that kid. I go, oh, I know what this is about in my 6-year-old brain. So his dad goes, I'm gonna fuck you up or whatever. Or apologize to my kid. And I go, I didn't do it. And the kid goes, actually, he didn't do it. It was his friend. So the dad goes, tell me where your friend lives right now. And I was terrified. Ooh. And something about my kid brain was like, no. Like, I would not tell him where Brian lived. Just wouldn't. It was like a block away from where we were. And I was like, nope. And I was like, nah, I'm not gonna, I don't even know him that well. And I like stood up to him. And he goes,
you
were
scared of like the 19-year-old boys from earlier.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You like ratted yourself out immediately.
Oh, it's like, it doesn't make any sense. So then, I guess I frustrated this guy so much. He goes, where do you live? And I go, here. And he gave me a ride home, and I just got out. Son of it's kidnapped her like a ride. But anyway. What's funny to me about that is if that happened to me today, like if somebody threw me in the back of a van, I'm like, where's your best friend live? I'd be like, 1842 Second Street. Anyway. Second time I got kidnapped was I was supposed to go home every day after school immediately because I drove the city bus to and from school because my parents lied about where our address was so I could go to a better public school. So I couldn't ride the school bus and I was too far to walk. So I would have to go and ride the city bus since I was like from like 7 to 10, I would ride the city bus across town by myself. So I get there, or so every day the rule was you come home on the same bus every night. And I missed it. I got like distracted. I don't know if you guys ever heard of Headliners. It's a store in San Francisco that's like Spencer's Gifts, but like I went to school in the gayest part of San Francisco, so Headliners had a bunch of like gay jokes on pins and stuff like that. And I used to walk through and just be like, ah! Like I just loved it. I stole a pin once that said I was raised by a pack of wild corn dogs, and I thought that was the funniest thing ever. So anyway, I got carried away and I didn't take the bus on that I was supposed to take. And I was so young, I didn't know that another bus was gonna come. I just thought that was the bus.
Oh, yeah.
So I was like, well, fuck me. Like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. And it's getting dark. It must have been winter. So I'm like, well, I know how to walk home. So I go to walk 2 miles across town in San Francisco. And I'm 7 years old. And I get through the middle of Castro. And I'm seven, and then there's no one around me. So a guy who is probably, like, a normal person. But he was obviously, I mean, it was like 100% gay. The guy goes, do you need help, little boy? And I go, ah, stranger danger. And I run into a store. And then I run out, and then I go home, and I make it all the way home safe. But it's like 7:30 p.m. My parents are freaking out. They didn't call the cops, but they were about to. I know how much trouble I'm in. But I'm like, if I scare them, they won't get mad at me.
Oh, smart.
Yeah. So my dad goes, what happened? And I go, I was going to ride the bus, and then a guy tried to take me. And my dad goes, all right, let's go find them. Like the other kids, Dad. Yeah.
Here's my name.
And I was like, what? I thought we would just be all happy that I made it. So we get in the car, and we drive back to Castro. And he goes, he parks, and he goes, all right, we're gonna. Now I get it as a parent. Like, my dad was like, I would do that, you know? I would be like, I'll find them. I'm Batman. So we get out, we're walking in the middle of Castro, and my dad goes, where did it happen? I go, right outside here. I'm like trying to play along. And he goes, let's go in this bar and see if you see anybody that you recognize. So he walks me into this gay bar. My dad and me, I'm seven, we look the same. And he goes, what did he look like? And I go, well, he had a mustache and jean shorts cut off and construction boots. And my dad went, fuck it, let's go home.
You need to get it together. That's like the eighth kid that I kidnapped and it's still not the right one.
Look, I don't know, it's dark. I couldn't see any. I have a bad memory.
I have to throw a damn pizza party to feed all these kids because of you.
The tin cup that you left for us is full. I really need to pee.
Dad, I think the next one will be right, though. I'm pretty sure.
Do you have to hold on to us? Can you just let us all go?
It's a pizza party, kids. It'll be fine.
I found a rat down here. Can I keep it?
Yes.
He was wearing a winter jacket.
Oh, come on, son.
It was red.
Not helping.
We've already watched Hocus Pocus 3 times. Can we get another DVD now?
You can only take so much, Batman.
We all can only take so much. Listen.
Oh, he looked like he had a sunny disposition.
This is Portland, so
I've forgotten how to use socks.
Oh, damn it. We gotta get rid of that dumb one.
Oh, hello, son. What's up, Chance Lab, to tell me your favorite wishes?
Dad!
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, all right, Bachelor Party 2016, right, guys? Ooh, yeah, right? That's what's happening right now, right?
Yeah.
Can you take the bag off my head?
Nope.
No, no,
nope.
Still standing.
Nope.
Okay,
stay
okay.
All right, we're going to tie you down a little bit.
Oh, wow, yeah, that's kinky. Whoa. Is there a
you were coming singing us up there.
Yeah.
Take your wallet.
Got that cell phone.
I can barely see. I really can't see through this burlap bag, guys.
Yeah, I do.
It's stuffy. It smells like potatoes.
That's your party. Is this your address where you live, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's the passcode to get into your
home? It's 9999. It's very simple.
Yeah, we're gonna talk to the stripper earlier.
Hey, stripper's here! Just a quick question!
Stripper.
What blood type are you?
Negative. It's
hey,
right.
Universal
right.
Donor! Alright!
Yeah. What the hell is that?
It's like S&M shit!
Oh, okay! Don't pierce my nipples or nothing!
It's more, we're gonna give you a liver piercing.
Oh, right. Wait, what?
What's your medical history? You smoke or anything?
No, I don't smoke. I'm helping the horse.
Great, man. This may feel sexy.
What are you giving me, a tattoo? What's happening here?
Oh, yeah, it's gonna say Bachelor
Party. Guys, I haven't had any alcohol, and that hurts a lot.
Oh, here's chloroform, but I'm saying.
Some ice.
Mm-hmm. And
what a rush that was!
Yeah. You feeling good?
Kind of woozy. That you kind of held chloroform over my face. Apparently, you have to hold it for a long time to really knock somebody out.
Oh my god!
Oh my god, Sarah. He gave you a fake number.
Yeah, it was a fake number. It was the wrong apartment.
What?
I know. I was like super pissed.
We're gonna go find him.
No, we should.
We are going to go find him.
Find him.
Dude, I'm freaking out.
No, it's okay, man.
This girl was just really, like, she was really into me. So I gave her a fake number. I think she's gonna find me.
Oh, it's fine.
No. I included four of my real numbers in the fake number.
Why?
She's gonna figure it out. There's only a 9,999 other phones numbers that could be.
Damn. Well, listen, that's a lot of numbers. There's no way she's gonna use all of them. I'm sure it's just your mom.
Can you answer that?
Yeah. What's your pocket?
Hello?
It's me. It's Sarah. I've tried 9945 numbers. And it's me.
I don't know what you're talking about. I just muted this. This is definitely her, man.
Who is it?
Hello! It's me.
Hey, what's up with me?
Not much. What do you do?
Bacon.
Okay. I've tried 994-4.
So yeah, she doesn't even want you anymore. She met some other guy. She's only calling to tell you that.
Oh, okay. Well, I guess I don't have to rappel out the window then.
Can you get that?
Hey, what's up? I'm about to have sex with this girl. I want to make sure she's clean. Can I, go talk to the owner of this phone?
I can tell you we don't know if she's clean.
Ask David. David knows.
I checked your background.
Yeah, Dad, those are my cigarettes, okay? But, the kids offered me cocaine, and I was like, nah, whatever, just give me just Marlboros. So, you're welcome. You're welcome.
Which kids?
What?
Which kids offered you cocaine?
Which kids?
You know, the ones down the streets.
Oh, the Mitchells?
No, different ones.
The Mitchells.
I didn't 100% know their name, because they said, hey, you want some cocaine? And I said,
looks like it's a job for Bat Dad.
Yeah, come on, man.
The Mitchells have been running drugs and cigarettes for years now. I've been waiting for an excuse.
Honey, be careful, okay? Wear your body armor now.
Will do.
All right, Mitchell family, get together for a casserole.
I'm so excited for this beautiful spread.
And I'm so glad that my mom ding, 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 ding.
Oh, we didn't set up for five.
Yeah, we can make do. Will you say less?
We'll just eat less.
I'll get an extra plate.
We're the drugs.
Okay, one last time.
Great job. Okay, let's see. One more. Give me another thing. Just yell out a word.
Unicorn.
Ocean. 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 Oh, okay. This one will be short and positive.
Oh.
Yeah. It'll be the opposite.
Of which one?
Of everything I've already said. So one time my friend Brian was like in college, he was like, "You ever been surfing?" And I was like, "No, we live in New Jersey. Like, what the fuck are you talking about?" And he goes, "I surf, you know?" And I go, "All right, well, no, I've never been surfing." He goes, "You should come." And I go, "It's January and we're in New Jersey." And he goes, "Do you want to come or not?" And I was like, "Yes." So he gives me a wetsuit. We go to the Jersey Shore in January. And it's like 40, it's like 36 degrees outside. And the water is 11 degrees, but it's moving a lot because it's the ocean, so it doesn't freeze. Oh. And I just made that up, but I feel like that's true. So I put on a wetsuit. I've never been in a wetsuit before. I don't trust them. I don't know what they do. And he gives me a longboard, and we go out, and I'm like freaking out. And I get in the water. I'm like, "Oh my god, these wetsuits work! Like, I'm not cold. You know, my face is gonna die, but like everything else is." And I start swimming. I'm paddling on a board, and I'm not a very good swimmer. And I start catching a wave. My body's surfed before, so whatever. But this was the first time on a board. And I get up and I stand on the board for the first time. And it was like three times I'd already failed, couldn't even stand up or get on my knees or whatever. So one time I get up on my feet. And I ride a wave that's probably this high on a longboard for like roughly 6 seconds. Like it was, right? But I felt so much power behind the ocean in that one little wave. And I felt I'd never felt that in my life. I was like, this is all fucking amazing. And I crashed and then it was made. And we got out, we went and I went home and got warm or whatever. And to this day, I was 18 years old. And I'm 37 now, and I've never gone back, and I've never felt anything that cool again, and I'm going to start surfing.
Yeah. All right, family, you quit complaining. It's not that cold.
And it's sort of cold.
No, it's not. Yeah. Myrtle Beach is cheaper in February. Shut up. You take off your cover up and you sunbathe.
Is that dead body?
Probably. Hey, you guys wanna touch the dead body?
No.
Myrtle Beach dead body.
Well, yeah, that's a free activity. Do it.
No, hey, $5 charge right there, buddy.
What?
Yeah,
you lost your mind.
All right, fine, you already touched it. Well, I gotta use condom over here, too. It is Myrtle Beach.
Can I touch that, Mom?
It's fine. Free interchange.
Yeah, okay.
Do it.
I don't wanna touch that.
Oh, wait, he's a
condom! Oh, wow, that's what he does. Wait, $5! That's like $5!
I don't know why he let her. She said very clearly what was gonna happen.
I thought he said condom.
No!
I'm out of time. Now gross things for you to touch.
Stop it! Stop!
We are gonna have a nice vacation.
Stop
it! You go out there in the ocean and you have a good time. You go. It's fine. Why are you still wearing a shirt?
I'm cold.
It's beach vacation.
Hi, buddy.
No, you go too.
There are more dead bodies.
You ever fucked a mermaid, Stan?
Oh, yeah, I fucked a mermaid. Are we talking like dolphins?
Oh my god.
dolphin was.
Stan, I met a woman with lady parts and fish parts. Did you fuck a dolphin?
You can't come back to the Sea World again.
Look, I gotta see her.
This is worse than that movie Blackfish.
Hello? Oh! I don't meet Missy no more. I got. Oh, Tillicum is ready.
I'm sorry, I don't believe in wetsuits, so I will not be wearing one.
Oh, that's fine. It's just, you know, it's gonna really chafe.
That's okay. For religious reasons, do not believe in wetsuits.
That's an unusual stance. I've never heard that before, but all right.
It is my right as an American to believe what I believe. I'm a Lutheran. With one difference, I do not believe in wetsuits.
That's fine. We don't have to wear. You don't have to. I'm gonna wear a wetsuit for my own protection.
That offends me. Would you walk into a mosque wearing a hijab? No, you're not. Unless you're a Muslim.
Listen. This is your place that we are about to.
I asked you to teach me how to surf, not to insult my heritage.
Right. Well.
Thank you.
First, go ahead and wax up this board real quick.
Oh, I'm sorry. There is one other slight doxology.
This is going to be like a wax thing?
From where I divide with the traditional Lutheran faith. I believe in naturally smooth surfboards.
I don't know if you've ever felt a surfboard, but it's not super smooth.
Religion's not supposed to be convenient. Unless, of course, I'm not allowed to do this because of my specific.
No, it's really
religion.
More that you just won't have any more chest skin or nipples after that. It's really just a purely, just a fact.
Is that more or less weird than circumcision?
If you don't.
Put me in the ocean now!
Listen, if you don't wear it, later, out in the ocean.
Oh,
I'm a scary octopus!
You know, I don't care what they say, Brad.
Yeah?
You can learn to rollerblade when you're 42.
Damn right you can.
Yeah.
I mean, my body parts still work the same, if slightly worse, they did when I was 20.
Yeah. I mean, like, getting better?
Yeah.
After getting hurt?
Don't do it. Look, it's me from your future, okay? Don't do it.
Why are you still wearing the roller skates?
Don't listen to him.
I went down the hill so fast. It bonded to my legs.
Hey, no, wait. It's me, yourself from the future. It turns out okay.
What?
No, it's good. Yeah.
No, it's me, future.
What?
It really doesn't, though.
What?
It doesn't
what?
Turn out okay.
But she was so cute.
Wait. I have a question. So, he went into the future or the past because he went real fast. But then how does... he become you? Does he go down the hill again?
I guess.
Why do you go into the future? Well, you think it's good. So
yeah,
are we just
great.
Keep going down this hill?
Today, on a very special episode of The Simpsons.
Listen, Homer, don't do it, Homer. It's
Homer,
me. Homer,
don't do
Homer.
It.
No, it turns out great.
Hold my beer.
It's me, blue hair. Outside. Can we give another round of applause for Julian? We have shows tomorrow night, Saturday night, workshops this weekend. Come hang out, visit newsouthcomedy.com for the schedule. If this looked like fun and you're not in Alchemy, which I think everyone is, visit alchemycomedy.com and sign up for classes. And woo! Have a good night!